Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to discuss the headquarters and taglines of the different banks. And this is the part one of the video. I've already told you that we are going to cover the static GK with this What, Why and Tell Me More series. Therefore, I've come up with the headquarters and taglines of the banks with the same concept of What, Why and Tell Me More. It would help you to remember it in much structured way. Now, there are two things which I am going to cover in this video, which are the headquarters and the second one are the taglines. As there are so many banks, therefore it is difficult to remember the headquarters of each bank. Therefore, I have decided to segregate the banks on the basis of the cities having the maximum number of headquarters. So suppose Mumbai is the city in which there are headquarters of almost 15 banks. So it would be easier for you to remember the headquarters city wise rather than remembering them the bank wise. So suppose take an example of Allahabad Bank. What do you think about the headquarters of Allahabad Bank? You would just assume it that as Allahabad is in UP, then the headquarters of Allahabad Bank are in UP. But this is an incorrect option as headquarters of Allahabad Bank is in Kolkata. Therefore, I would advise you that if you keep on revising by this method of the maximum number of cities, then it would definitely become easier to remember the headquarters of all the banks. Now, coming to the taglines, I believe that it is almost impossible for you to remember the taglines of each and every bank if you mug up the taglines. And I would suggest you not to make the short tricks for taglines. You would find out the short tricks for remembering the taglines on various websites, but I would suggest you not to go with it as you will end up making more or new short tricks for the already created short tricks. Now, there are two methods to remember the taglines. The first one is the listening method. So what happens is, suppose I say dimag ki batti jala de. Before even completing the tagline, you know that this tagline is for mentors. As you have heard about this tagline or you have heard this tagline so many times on television that you know that it is related to the mentors. Or if I say no confusion, great combination, you know that the advertisement of Matt Angles has it. Tagline. If we take the example of banks, then when you hear the Badhti ka naam zindagi, you know that it is Axis Bank because you have heard about it so many times. So this is the first way to remember the taglines. Another way is the visual method, and this is the method I am going to use in this video to make you understand and learn the taglines of different banks. Now, what is this visual method? As you know that it is much easier for you to remember things if we can visualize things. Suppose I say SBI, you would relate it to the blue and white color because you remember that the logo of the SBI is in blue and white color. Therefore, it becomes easy for you to visualize the picture when I say SBI. Before starting with the video, I'm going to tell you about the 14 banks which were nationalized in 1969 and another 6 banks which were nationalized in the 1980 drive. So these are the 14 banks: Central Bank of India, Bank of Maharashtra, Dena Bank, Punjab National Bank, Syndicate, Canara, Indian Overseas, Bank of Baroda, Union Bank, Allahabad, United Bank of India, UCO Bank and the Bank of India. And the banks which were nationalized in 1980, Andhra Bank, Punjab and Sindh Bank, New Bank of India, Vijaya Bank, Corporation Bank and the Oriental Bank of Commerce. I'm going to discuss all these banks in this series and some more information about these banks. What is the meaning of the nationalization? So basically, nationalization is an act of taking an industry or the assets into the public ownership of the natural government. So when the private assets are being transferred to the public sector and they are being operated or owned by the state, then it becomes the nationalization. Before starting with the video, I would tell you the why of the taglines. Now what is the purpose of taglines or why the banks come up with the tagline? So bank come up with the tagline so that it could distinguish itself from the other banks. So once you hear about the once you listen the tagline of a particular bank, it would be easier for you to relate to that bank. Therefore, every time a bank has a tagline, they want you or they want the customers to relate to the bank. In this part one, I am going to discuss all the banks which have their headquarters in Mumbai. So this is the list of the banks which have their headquarters in Mumbai: the State Bank of India, Bank of India, IDBI, Central Bank of India, Dena Bank, Yes Bank, Axis, HDFC, ICICI, Union Bank of India, DCB Bank, IndusLand Bank, Kotak Mahindra, RBL and IDFC Bank. These are some of the major banks which are there in India. If you once or twice write down the banks which are there in Mumbai, you would be able to remember the name of the banks. The first bank is the State Bank of India. So what is the tagline of the State Bank of India? It is the banker to every Indian. Now, how you are going to remember this tagline? So whenever the question comes in the examination regarding the SBI, you are going to frame the picture or you are going to visualize the picture of the logo of the State Bank of India and try to visualize this image with the tagline. So the tagline is the banker to every Indian. So every time you revise the headquarters and taglines of the banks, you are going to visualize the image with the tagline. Thus, it would become so much easier for you to remember the tagline. Now coming to the tell me more of State Bank of India. So the origin of State Bank of India goes to the first decade of the 19th century when the Bank of Calcutta was established in Calcutta in the year 1806. The year is important over here. Then what happened in the year 1809? The Bank of Calcutta was renamed to Bank of Bengal. This is again an important point. And apart from Bank of Bengal, the Bank of Bombay and Bank of Madras, which were established in the year 1840 and 1843 respectively, these were the three banks which were funded by the British government at that point of time. Therefore, it is again the important information to note here. So what happened in 1921 was the Bank of Bombay and the Bank of Madras were merged to form the Imperial Bank of India. At that time, RBI wasn't there. So Imperial Bank of India was the central bank, or we could say the quasi-central bank, which was formed in the year 1921. And when was RBI established? So RBI was established in the year 1935. So there are so many questions which could be framed from this information itself. When was the Bank of Calcutta established? So it happened in the year 1806. The Bank of Calcutta was renamed to the Bank of Bengal, the second question. Or which banks were merged to form the Imperial Bank of India? The answer would be the Bank of Bengal, Bank of Bombay and Bank of Madras. And when was RBI established? So RBI was established in the year 1935. So what happened in the year 1955? So under the State Bank of India Act 1955, State Bank of India was constituted on 1st July 1955. If we come to the recent information, then with effect from April 1st, 2017, the State Bank of Bikaner and Jaipur, the State Bank of Hyderabad, the State Bank of Mysore, the State Bank of Patiala, and the State Bank of Travancore, besides the Bharatiya Mahila Bank, were merged with the SBI. So this is some of the important information and the tagline of State Bank of India. Moving on to the next bank, which is Bank of India. So what is the tagline of Bank of India? It is relationships beyond banking. So whenever you look at the logo of the Bank of India, it would state that it is relationships beyond banking. Therefore, again, I would tell you that visualize the picture and then conclude the answer for the tagline. So Bank of India was founded in 1906 on 7th September and it was done by the group of eminent businessmen from Mumbai. The bank was under the private ownership and control till the year 1969 when it was nationalized along with the 13 other banks. As I mentioned in the previous slides that Bank of India was among the banks which were nationalized in the year 1969. So again, what is the tagline? Bank of India has the tagline relationships beyond banking. Next bank is IDBI Bank. There was so much news about the IDBI Bank as LIC is going to buy 51% stake in IDBI. And therefore the question was framed in RBI Grade B examination. So what is the tagline of IDBI Bank? It is banking for all. Aao soche bada. And another tagline is bank aisa dost jaisa. You might be able to visualize the picture of IDBI Bank with its logo when the name of IDBI Bank is being stated. But try to remember the picture with the tagline. So the information about IDBI Bank. So IDBI Bank was constituted under the Industrial Development Bank of India Act 1964. First of all, what is the full form of IDBI Bank? It's Industrial Development Bank of India. It was constituted in the year 1964. And came into being as the development financial institution. Apart from this, it continued to serve as the development financial institution for 40 years till the year 2004 when it was transformed into a bank. So earlier IDBI Bank was the development financial institution and in the year 2004 it was transformed into the Bank. Apart from this, the United Western Bank of India Limited, which is a Satara-based private sector bank, it was merged with the IDBI Bank on October 3, 2006. What is important in this point is the name of the bank, the United Western Bank Limited, which was merged with the IDBI Bank. The name of the IDBI Bank was changed to the IDBI Bank Limited, and it happened with effect from the May 7, 2008. Apart from this, if we talk about the merger of LIC and which is Life Insurance Corporation of India and IDBI Bank. So IDBI Bank received the letter from insurance company, the LIC, for raising its stake to 51%, and LIC already holds 10.82% of stake in IDBI. But what happened was the existing, according to the existing rules of the Insurance Regulatory Development Authority of India, which is IRDAI, the regulations do not permit LIC to raise its shareholding to 51%, as an insurance company cannot hold beyond 15% in a bank. But this was an exemption made by the IRDAI for LIC, therefore the merger is about to conclude in September 2018. Why the different information about the bank is important? So that you can relate it to the bank and frame the tagline for the same. The next is the Central Bank of India, which has a tagline, build a better life around us, or central to you since 1911. Now, this would help you to remember the establishment year of the Central Bank of India, and again the tagline, which is central to you since 1911. This is quite an easy tagline. It would relate it to the Central Bank of India. The name itself is over here. Central to you since 1911. The Central Bank of India was established in the year 1911 and was the first Indian commercial bank, which was wholly owned and managed by the Indians. The bank was again among the banks which were nationalized in the year 1969 by RBI. Moving on to the next bank, the Dena Bank, which has the tagline Trusted Family Bank. Dena hai to bharosa hai. And Dena Bank was founded on 26th May 1938 by a family of Devkaran Nanji under the name of Devkaran Nanji Banking Company Limited. Apart from this, it became the public limited company in December 1939. And later the same year, the name was changed to the Dena Bank Limited. You might have seen the Experience Our Expertise tagline on every logo of Yes Bank. So the tagline of Yes Bank is Experience Our Expertise, and Yes Bank was incorporated as a public limited company on November 21st, 2003. As I discussed about the Axis Bank in the beginning of this slide, that Badhti ka naam zindagi, you would be able to. So when the name Axis Bank comes to your mind, you would be able to visualize the logo of the Axis Bank. So try to visualize the logo with the tagline, which is Badhti ka naam zindagi. So Axis Bank was earlier known as the UTI Bank, and due to the confusion of the brand name UTI, which is the United Trust of India, the name of the bank was officially changed to Axis Bank Limited with effect from 30th July 2007. But originally the UTI Bank opened its registered office in the year December 1993. The next bank is the ICICI Bank, which has the tagline Khayal Aapka and Hum Hai Na. ICICI stands for the Industrial Credit and Investment Corporation of India, and this bank was originally promoted in 1994 by the ICICI Limited. This ICICI Limited was an Indian financial institution which was formed in the year 1955 at the initiative of the World Bank, the Government of India and the representatives of the Indian industry. So what was the principal objective of ICICI Limited? It was to create the development financial institution. So it was development financial institution at the time of the establishment, and it used to provide the medium term and the long term project financing to the Indian businesses. Later in the year 1990s, the ICICI transformed its business from the development financial institutions to a diversified financial services group, and it started offering a wide variety of products and services both directly and through the number of subsidiaries. Even the ICICI Bank was the subsidiary of ICICI Limited. Then in the year October 2001, the board of directors of ICICI and ICICI Bank approved the merger of the ICICI and the ICICI Personal Financial Services Limited and the ICICI Capital Services Limited with the ICICI Bank. Therefore, the ICICI Personal Financial Services Limited and the Capital Services Limited was merged with the ICICI to form the ICICI Bank. Next is the HDFC Bank. The tagline of HDFC Bank is "We understand your world." The HDFC Bank, which stands for the Housing Development Financial Corporation Limited, was among the first to receive the in-principle approval from the RBI to set up a bank in the private sector. And it was done as a part of the RBI's liberalization policy of the Indian banking industry in the year 1994. So when was the liberalization of the Indian banking industry held? It was done in the year 1994. The bank was then incorporated in August 1994 in the name of the HDFC Bank Limited. And again, it commenced the operations as a scheduled commercial bank in the year January 1995. As I told you that HDFC was the first bank to receive the license from RBI during the RBI liberalization policy. Let's look at the RBI liberalization policy. So when RBI came into the picture in 1935, it became the center of every bank, taking away all the responsibilities and functions of the imperial bank. Now, in the early 1990s, RBI liberalization policy came in the picture and government gave license to few private banks, and we could categorize the private banks in two categories. The first one is the old private banks and the second one we can say the new private banks. So, old private banks are the ones which are operating since a long time or before 1991. These are considered as old private banks. What about the new private banks? So all those banks that have commenced their business after 1991 are considered as the new private banks. What happened in January 1993? The RBI Central Board approved the proposal to license new private banks. And entry barriers were actually high at that particular point of time, with a minimum capital of rupees 100 crores and a capital adequacy ratio of 8%. To begin with, RBI decided to provide the in-principle approval. So which were the three banks which got the in-principle approval? So they were UTI, the name of which has been changed to Axis Bank now. The second one was ICICI Bank. And the third one is IDBI Bank. So these were the three banks which got the in-principle approval, and there were later six more licenses which were issued by RBI. But the first bank to receive the license was HDFC Bank. After that, in 2003 or the 2004, two new licenses were issued, one to the Kotak Mahindra and the Rabo Bank, which is now known as Yes Bank. So what all information is important? The establishment year of RBI, the old and the new private banks, the in-principle approval given to the banks UTI, ICICI and IDBI, and the name of the Rabo Bank, which is now known as the Yes Bank. So this is the brief about the RBI's private bank licensing. The next bank is the Union Bank of India, and the tagline for the same is "Good people to bank with." The Union Bank of India was established in the year 1919 on 11th November, and shortly after the nationalization in 1969, so Union Bank of India was among the list of the banks which were nationalized in the year 1969. The Union Bank of India acquired the Belgaum Bank, which is a private sector bank established in the 1930. Apart from this, in 1985, Union Bank of India acquired the Miraj State Bank, and in the 1919, the Reserve Bank of India requested the Union Bank to acquire the Sikkim Bank. So three banks which were acquired by Union Bank of India, the first one being the Belgaum Bank, it was done after 1969. Then in 1985, it acquired Miraj State Bank, and in 1999, it acquired Sikkim Bank. The next is the IDFC Bank Limited. First of all, IDFC stands for the Infrastructure Development Financial Company, and IDFC has the tagline "Banking Hatke." It was incorporated in the year 1997. In 1998, the company registered itself with the RBI as a non-banking financial company, as in NBFC. And in 1999, it formally became a public financial institution. Formally, it was launched in the year 2015, quite a recent bank which was formed. Next is the Kotak Mahindra Bank Limited, quite an important bank. So the tagline says, "Let's make money simple, up Kona Kona Kotak." You might have heard about this "up Kona Kona Kotak" so many times that you know that it is related to the Kotak Mahindra Bank. So Kotak Mahindra Finance Limited in the year 2003 received the banking license from RBI and it became the first non-banking financial company. So earlier it was NBFC to be converted into a bank which was named as Kotak Mahindra Bank Limited, KMB Limited. This is an important point. In 2015, Kotak Bank acquired ING VSI Bank. RBL Bank Limited, which was formerly known as Ratnakar Bank Limited, it has the tagline Apno Ka Bank. And in the year August 1943, the Ratnakar Bank was a regional bank in Maharashtra and it was rebranded and portrayed under a new name, which is RBL Bank in mid-year 2014. So the name change happened in the year 2014. Apart from this, in August 1959, the bank was categorized as a scheduled commercial bank under the Reserve Bank of India Act 1934. The next bank over here is the IndusLand Bank Limited, which has the tagline, "We care dil se, we make you feel richer." And the bank began its operations on the 17th April 1994. And as the Indus is over here, so it derived its name from the Indus Valley Civilization. This is all for the banks which are headquartered in Mumbai. I would be coming up with the rest of the banks in the next part of the video. If you like the video, please subscribe to the channel Anuj Jindal and press the bell icon, as it would become so much easier for you to receive the video whenever it is posted on the YouTube. Apart from this, do tell us about the What, Why and Tell Me More series in the comment section below. Share these videos with your friends and other people who are preparing for the banking examination, and I believe that this would definitely be help for them. We have a YouTube community as well, which you can join and get the latest updates and announcements regarding the courses and the other video materials. If you wish to download the document for this video, the link is already mentioned in the description. Do download the document and go through it. Thank you for watching the video.